My experience of being at Central St Martins is it's quite a dynamic and multidisciplinary space. I was an undergraduate here and I studied fashion women's wear, and then I went on to study on the MA Material Futures course.
As a course, we're exploring the future of materiality, so we're looking really at the intersection of craft, science and technology. Our designers, our students are really interested in finding new applications for those materials.
I'm a speculative designer and I was very much interested in looking at the future of footwear design and how emerging technologies could impact the way we run in the future. These trainers are based on Dr. Martin Hanzik's work on protocell technology.
I am a new researcher here in Trento, Italy, and my research is a bit different. It's a bit more frontier science, where we're looking at adaptive materials, materials that are intimately linked to their environment, in a way that we could basically try to produce something that we would term living materials.
One of the incentives for studying artificial life models like the ones we study here are to give us a better understanding of living systems, because we have, from humans, animals, bacteria and plants, the same kind of architecture. We have the same kind of DNA, we have the same kinds of proteins that make up all aspects of life as we know it.
The science of protocell has been very much looking at the origins of life and trying to establish that kind of understanding from the bottom-up approach. It was quite unusual in my case that I took an interest into that kind of technology.
So one of the unique angles of this kind of research is that we're making these artificial chemical systems that are intimately coupled with their environment. What that means is we have a simple chemical system that is now in communication with its immediate environment.
We also have a lot of students that are interested in sort of the capabilities of synthetic biology and applying these synthetically engineered materials for new design applications.
The idea and the concept behind these trainers is that they will adapt to the individuals as they're running. They'll be more in tune with the individual's foot and reconfigure and adapt depending on the pressure and the time.
One of the futuristic visions for a new kind of material, new kind of living material, is that you would have a structure that is self-repairing, perhaps self-growing, self-reproducing even. These are very futuristic visions, and we haven't realized anything like this yet. But it is a way to think about the future and what kind of technologies can be applied.
This is a very much a futuristic proposal of the potential footwear trainers within 2050. I was really interested in what potentially nature could offer us in terms of a more sustainable and dynamic material.
We're combining sort of near and further future approaches in terms of thinking about applications for new materials, but all of it, what we're trying to encourage is a very context-driven approach, so it's all research-driven. So we're particularly looking at trying to define emerging needs and then how these new materials can actually fit into responding to these needs, so we don't get to the situation where it's just technology for the sake of technology, that it's actually effectively helping us to live better, more effectively, more sustainably.
So an open question of this type of research is, what are we making and what kind of purpose can it serve in the future? What we are trying to develop here is a technology that is more organic, more fluid, and more similar in type to the things that make up our bodies, cellular-based systems. We could imagine there's a more harmonious interaction between a human user and the technology.